Hello viewers, welcome to the channel. Now MacOut already has given its examination notification with respect to their end semester examination both for final year as well as for intermediate students. And as you are aware of, the dates of the examination for the final year students has been preponed such that the final result for the final year students can be taken out in the month of July itself. Whereas the intermediate students will have their examination in the month of August and the probable next session to start from the end week of August or early September. Now, because of the second wave, it is impossible to conduct a physical form of examination. Therefore, university is clear about the fact that it will be an online mode, rather an online MCQ examination. We will just go into the details related to the guidelines for online semester examination last time, just to revise the guidelines which require to be followed by the students related to online examination under MacOut. To start on with, the students require to visit the login portal, and it is mandatory that the latest Google Chrome browser has to be downloaded in the system if you are using a laptop or a desktop. So student, it is absolutely essential that you check from now itself or download the latest Google Chrome browser which will be required in coming days from the point of view of your examination. The students, so once you have entered the examination page, you require to hit the student tab, and thereafter you have to use your username and password to log in. So once you have logged in the dashboard, you will see the event semester online examination tab. Now this is an example related to odd semester template. So it is being showing odd semester, but for you, 1 week before the examination, you will find the event semester online examination tab to appear in the dashboard. Now once you click on to the tab of this event semester online exam as shown in the icon, you enter into a page which is the exam form, and a URL is already there. Now once you click the URL, again you require to log in to the examination portal with your user ID and password. Now this is important, student. You require to log in from a single device, that is either a laptop or else a desktop or else from your mobile phone. You will not be allowed for a multiple login, and if you are already logged in from multiple devices, you will get a warning like this that you are already logged in with the same credential in different devices. So what you require to log out from the other devices and try to log in from the main device with which you are going to give the examination. So this is the second important point. The first important point was the latest Google Chrome has to be downloaded, and point number two, you require to log in from a single device. So it can be your laptop, a desktop or else a mobile phone. No multiple login. Next comes related to the instruction of the examination, the list of subjects which you require to give, and as you are aware of, you require to compulsorily sit for mock examination. These mock tests are normally taken by the university to make you familiarize with the process. The marks are not added. So you require to appear for the mock examination to be conducted by the university, and then only you will be eligible to get the admit card. This is the third important point, that you have to appear for the mock examination, otherwise you will not be eligible to sit for the examination. Now after selecting the subject which has been given here, the list of all subjects, the first time they will be checking your photo identity and allow you to enter into the online examination room. Because this is the information which is there, now you require to check your camera as well as the browser button. And this is the examination information dashboard, which talks about the mock examination, the total number of questions to be there, the total marks to be there, which will not be added in your course curriculum, the total duration of the examination, and the total time remaining for the examination. So once you click and get into the next page, you require to give certain approval related to 5 important parameters. So after successful checking your desktop, laptop, camera and browser, now you have moved into the authenticity part, where you have 5 options where a green tick has to happen. In case you are getting a red cross mark, you require to read the instructions properly, because you are not giving access to certain points. The 5 points are the browser check, the support for the latest Google Chrome, the webcam device permission, the device system permission and the webcam permission. So this points required to be taken into consideration. You have to give approval. If you don't give approval, your examination is not going to start. You also require to take a photo. So uploading photo is mandatory and may take some time as per your internet's connectivity speed or your bandwidth. And you are requested not to refresh while you are uploading the photo. So this is the fourth important point, where you require to give permission to all the 5 points, as well as you require to upload your picture. And do not refresh. You take a picture and try to upload it. Don't refresh the page until and unless it gets uploaded. So once this is done, you will see that the browser check has been completed and it is a green tick with a green tab, which means the entire process has been successfully completed. And then again, you come back to the exam instruction area. And now you are eligible to start the exam. Now all examination will start at the scheduled time with respect to the timetable, exam timetable, which will be given by the university or notified by the university. You can log in at least 30 to 45 minutes before the start of the exam to complete the process. And please understand, the remaining time will also be shown in the panel with reference to your examination. So once you click on to the start exam, this is the next window which is going to come. The question on the screen will auto-load and you require to wait. By the time your webcam device and the webcam device permission checking will be taken into consideration, where you are already permitted, so that particular check again will be done. And once it is done, you will enter into the examination window. So this is the examination screen. You can see it's an MCQ based examination where you have 4 options and one of the options will be the right option. On the extreme left hand side, there is a panel of all the questions mentioned. At the bottom part, you will find mark for review. If you want to answer that particular question afterwards, you can mark for review, or else you can save and continue if you have already answered the question. At the top, visited, the number of questions you have visited. Not visited, that means still you haven't visited those questions or you haven't seen those questions. Reviews, the number of questions you have kept in review, you will be attending afterwards, and the time left for the examination. So left hand side is the portal or the panel where all the questions are there. This is the question, this is the answer. You have to select one, you have to save and continue. You can check how many questions you have visited, how many are yet to visit, how many you are going to attend afterwards, and the time left for the examination. Since it's a proctored examination, kindly note, the university call center will be monitoring students via their webcam, and therefore such kind of message might come if there is any unfair practice or malpractice is done by any student. So moving on, as I said, that you require to save and continue. I have already answered this particular MCQ. I have selected C for the third answer. I will save and continue. So click onto the save and continue button to go to the next question. And once you will complete all the questions answered, you will get save and finish. So let's go through it. So let me say, for example, I have attempted all the questions and thereafter I will get save and finish. Now in case you want to straightway move into question number 8, so you can click question number 8 and then go to question number 8. So I might be in question number 23. Now I want to check question number 8, so I can straightway click question 8 and question 8 will be there. And I can straightway answer question number 8 and 7 continue. And you will also find a previous button to go to the previous question. That means this is question number 23. So if I want to go to question number 22, I can click here in the panel and then go to question 22, or else I can click the previous and then go to question number 22. And as I said, once I have submitted the 23rd question or attempted the 23rd question, I will get save and finish subject button. So I require to click this to submit my examination. Lastly, after submitting the paper, the system will redirect you straightway back to the home page, and you require to log out from the examination. And this will be the button which will be there in the top right corner. You require to log out from the examination. So this is all about the entire examination mode or the guidelines which the students require to follow for the upcoming even semester examination, both for final year as well as for the intermediate semester. It is an MCQ examination, an online MCQ examination, like the way you have given your previous semester examination. There are a few things which has to be taken into consideration. Firstly, a proper Google Chrome browser. Secondly, you require to appear for the mock test, and then only admit card will be issued. If you are not attending the mock test, you will not be eligible to sit for the examination. Thirdly, while giving the examination, you require to give permission for your webcam. You require to take a photo. You require to upload those photo and follow each and every instruction steps. In details, I have talked about the dashboard. You require to attempt all the questions. And at very last, you require to save and finish the examination, which will direct you to the home page, and then you have to log out from the examination. So this is all about the guidelines for the online semester examination for 2021, which will be the event semester examination. More or less the guidelines will remain the same. So I thought about revising the entire thing for the students. Moreover, videos relating to examination, education and other processes, you will get updated videos from this channel. So viewers, be associated with this channel. Till then, thank you. Take care. All the best for the examination.